Hello everyone. In this video lecture, I am going to explain the diminishing value method to determine the depreciation charges. This is a part of unit number 6B, Economics of Power Generation. And here it is mentioned in the syllabus that is methods to determine the depreciation cost. Following are the commonly used methods for determining the annual depreciation charge. The first one is the straight line method, already I explained in the previous video. Diminishing value method that I am going to explain in this present video. And third one is the sinking fund method that I am going to explain in the next video. In this method, the depreciation charge is made every year at a fixed rate on the diminished value of the equipment. In other words, depreciation charge is first applied to the initial cost of equipment and then to its diminished value. Diminished value means that is the decreased value. As an example, suppose the initial cost of equipment is rupees 10,000 and its scrap value after the useful life is 0. If the annual rate of depreciation is 10%, then the depreciation charge for the first year will be 10% of 10,000 is equal to rupees 1,000. The value of the equipment is diminished by rupees 1,000 and becomes rupees 9,000. That is 10,000 minus this 1,000, that is 9,000. For the second year, the depreciation charge will be made on the diminished value, that is rupees 9,000, and becomes 10% of 9,000 is 900. The value of the equipment now at the end of second year becomes 9,000 minus 900, that is rupees 8,100. For the third year, the depreciation charge will be 10% of 8,100, that is rupees 810, and so on. Let P be the capital cost of the equipment, N is the useful life of the equipment in years, and S is the scrap value of after useful life. Suppose the annual unit depreciation is X. It is desired to find the value of X in terms of P, N and S. Value of equipment after 1 year is equal to P minus PX, that is P in bracket 1 minus X. Value of equipment after second year is equal to diminished value minus annual depreciation. So diminished value at the end of second year is equal to P in bracket P minus PX minus X times P minus PX, that is annual depreciation. So by following this, we will get the at the value of equipment after second year is equal to P in bracket 1 minus X raised to 2. Therefore, the value of the equipment after N years is equal to P in bracket 1 minus X raised to N. If annual depreciation is 10%, then we can say that annual unit depreciation is 0.1. But the value of the equipment after N years, that is useful life, is equal to the its salvage value or scrap value, that is denoted by the capital S. So therefore, the S is equal to P in bracket 1 minus X raised to N, or 1 minus X raised to N is equal to S by P. By solving this, we will get the expression for X is equal to 1 minus S by P raised to 1 by N. From the above expression, the annual depreciation can be easily found. Thus, the depreciation to be made for the first year is given by depreciation for the first year is equal to X into P, that is P in bracket 1 minus S by P raised to 1 by N. Similarly, the annual depreciation charge for the subsequent years can be calculated, and we'll get the such type of the nature of the diagram which have been plotted, value of the equipment versus that is age of the equipment. So this is the nature of the curve. Thank you. We'll stop here.